following presentation will outline the University of Vermont's Englesby House Stormwater Management Project. Team members for this project included Alex Morton, Tony Leonard, AJ Goetz, and Jai Yi Wan. The UVM Englesby House, or the President's House, and adjacent properties are located on the southwest edge of the main UVM campus. This site is subject to high runoff volumes during storm events due to the surrounding impervious surfaces and poor infiltration rates from clay soils. Luce Hillman and Scott Goodwin from the UVM Physical Plant tasked this group to develop possible stormwater remediation designs to prevent flooding and erosion of the overall site location. Phase 1, completed in the summer of 2014, involved the installation of a drainage system to help alleviate flooding in the Wheeler House basement. This was accomplished through the installation of a series of catch basins and an infiltration trench. The Phase 2 designs were intended to slow the movement of stormwater and decrease the rate of erosion within the Englesby yard. As requested by our community partners, a 2-year, 24-hour rainstorm was considered for each Phase 2 design alternative. The first option considered was the installation of a 7,500-gallon underground storage tank either in the Jacobs House yard or the yard of 439 College Street. ArcMap was used to estimate the runoff areas at the site. HydroCAD, a stormwater modeling software, was used to estimate the runoff volumes as well as the size of the tank required. The City of Burlington requires that all outflow into the Combined Sewer Overflow System, or CSO, be limited to 0.13 cubic feet per second. In order to restrict the outflow, a 1 3/8-inch orifice is to be installed at the bottom of the tank. A 12-inch outflow pipe, however, will be put at the top of the tank to handle extreme storm events. In order for the storage tank to be installed at 439 College Street, a catch basin would need to be installed in order to disrupt the current path of preferential flow from the Wheeler House parking lot. The second Phase 2 option involved the construction of a bioretention cell with a grass-lined swale. In order for the cell to function properly, the depth to water table needs to be at least 6 feet. The swale is meant to transport the water from the Wheeler House yard to the bioretention cell located in the yard of 439 College Street, as well as act as a barrier to prevent the water from flowing into the Englesby yard. The area on top of the cell was designed to contain native vegetation. This will have the effect of increasing evapotranspiration, slowing the flow through the cell, and allowing the water to collect and percolate through the soil. The planting media also acts as a filter for sediment, nutrients, and contaminants, preventing them from entering the CSO and eventually Lake Champlain. A perforated PVC pipe will be installed at the bottom of the cell to act as an underdrain to direct water to the CSO system. The purpose of Phase 3 was to reduce flooding and icing on South William Street. This phase, however, may or may not be necessary depending on the effectiveness of Phase 2. To increase the embankment stability, a VersaLock retaining wall was suggested. VersaLock blocks provide an aesthetically pleasing and relatively inexpensive design that complements the historical layout of South William Street. The wall will be approximately 300 feet long and 4 feet tall. To capture groundwater seepage, a 4-inch perforated pipe should be buried near the bottom of the wall. The PVC pipe will also be connected to the CSO system. The 6 permits required for this project include planning and zoning, construction, erosion prevention and sediment control plan, excavation, curb cut, and obstruction. Displayed here are the cost estimates for each design alternative previously mentioned. These costs include labor, materials, permitting fees, and contractor fees. Long-term costs for the project would include cleaning the sump for both the storage tank and the catch basin, as well as maintenance for the plants and the bioretention cell. Before starting the construction of Phase 2 or Phase 3, it is recommended that the infiltration trenches be properly monitored during the 2015 rainy season from April through June. This will help save money on future remediation designs by knowing the efficiency of the trench. Since the primary goal of this project was to stop flooding into the Englesby House yard, the bioretention cell will be the first alternative constructed if the depth to the water table is at least 6 feet below the surface. According to the Natural Resources Conservation Service, the depth to the water table is at least 80 inches. However, it is recommended the depth to the water table be found once the ground is thawed. It is further recommended that the VersaLock retaining wall be constructed after the drainage problems on the property have been solved. It is entirely possible that the Phase 1 or Phase 2 solutions will alleviate the sheet flow across the Englesby House property enough that Phase 3 will not be required. Sadly, not all designs were used, but they were still near and dear to our hearts. Let's take a quick look back at the designs that didn't make the cut.
How many roads must a man walk down before you call him a man? How many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? isn't how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Special thanks to Luce Hillman, Scott Goodwin, Dr. DeWolcar, Dr. Pierce, Kate Johnson, Dr. Bomblace, Alexis Doshis, friends and family.